Hello and welcome to Flying Around the World. This is a one-off video, as flying an airliner isn't appealing to most people, I would imagine.
So, here we are, East Midlands Airport in the middle of England. We've just borrowed this 737. I'm sure they won't mind. It's just sitting on the tarmac.
No one was using it. Doesn't look like security has spotted us yet. Flying a 737 is quite easy. You just have to push buttons and levers and stuff, and it practically flies itself.
So, Scott has turned the plane on. It's running on batteries at the moment. We're gonna fly over to Dublin for a nice day trip. It's just a short flight over the Irish Sea.
That's the fuel pumps going on. Engines are gonna need fuel. Can't believe that just left this fully fueled plane here. That the AP, which is a small engine in the back of the plane,
it's used to start up the proper engines. Just gotta wait until it's fired up.
That dial has to settle down.
Just a little disclaimer. Stealing an aircraft may be illegal in your country, so just check with your local police if it's okay to borrow a 737 airliner without permission. You're also supposed to ask for permission to take off and land, but we're not bothering with that. Just want to get over to Dublin and get me some Guinness. That's the APU generators going on, so the batteries don't go flat. This is the flight management computer. You use it like a sat nav in your car.
HGNX is the airport code of where we are.
It's a dumb sat nav if you have to tell it where you are.
IDEBL is the airport code for Dublin. Now it does make sense to tell it where you want to go. Scott doesn't actually know what these bits do, just types random numbers in there.
is a bit of guesswork. You have to choose your departure path and your arrival path. Just take your best guess. You have to tell the FMC an awful lot of information. That's the flaps, which do not flap. They help the aircraft take off and land, but to be clear, they do not flap like a bird flaps their wings. This is sort of the autopilot, where you set what speed you want to go, and the altitude, and things like that. Finally, we can start the engines. This plane has two engines. Doesn't look like security has spotted us yet. Click means the right-hand engine is up to speed, so Scott can start the left-side engine, and we can get the hell out of here. And that click means the left side engine is good to go. Now Scott is switching the main engine generators on, and the APU can be switched off. Okay, let's get out of here before security shows up and ruins our day trip to Dublin. This is normal. Scott does this every time. Is that police cars chasing us? Yes, we're up in the sky.
400.
Let's head to Dublin. Just gonna hide in the clouds for a bit. As soon as we reach that next waypoint, we'll start to go right up to 20,000 feet. Here we go. I'll be glad to be out of this cloud. Glad I can take my seatbelt off. Scott is tuning the navigation radio to pick up the Dublin ILS. That will make landing a lot easier. When we're in range, we should hear the Morse code from the beacon. Quite a long way to go. We've reached the cruising altitude of 20,000 feet. Okay, so the rest of the flight is a bit boring, so we'll be right back when we start approaching Dublin. Scott started drinking at the airport lounge. If you plan on borrowing an airliner yourself, I'd recommend not drinking beer your first time. After you've done this a few times like me and Scott, feel free to get wasted before your flight. It makes it a whole lot more fun. Anywho, we'll be right back when we're arriving at Dublin. Scott kinda messed up when programming the flight plan. It's got us on a weird route to get to the runway, so Captain Scott will be doing it the old-fashioned way and flying a more direct route. The Snowdonia mountain range in Wales. You can see the batshit crazy flight plan here. We're now starting our descent down. We'll be landing soon. That's the Morse code beacon for the AL. ALS? We can lock onto it to guide the aircraft in.
Thank you.
Right, this is it. Everything looks good, so we shouldn't crash at all.
Feet stabilized, Mr. Birch altitude set.
Scott has took the autopilot off and is flying manually now.
We did it. Well, Scott did. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have fun borrowing an airliner from your local airport. It is so much fun. Okay, we're gonna ditch the plane here and run over to hide in those fields over there. Then head for the nearest Dublin pub for a pint or two. Remember to click the like button, otherwise next time, we'll be throwing kittens out the door at 20,000 feet.